gives a man a full heart a welcome like this. Gives a man an empty pocket a welcome like that. Visit. I think he's going to the library. Who was it who said, "For malt doth more than Milton can to recreate the working man"? Either she's describing an angel she met, or they're still talking about hats. Saturday can mean so many things at Glenrothes. The leisurely click of bowls, long shadows on the green, and good company. In the summertime, the beach, only a few miles away, sea and sun and sky, and the shimmering horizon, and the wonderful feeling of doing nothing, and knowing that it's good for you. For nearly 9 months of the year, there's football. East Fife at Methil or Raith Rovers at Kirkcaldy, both within easy reach. Sometimes there's nothing more pleasant than a stay-at-home Saturday, especially when you have the kind of house that makes staying at home a pleasure. George has discovered that he has a green thumb. His roses, when he doesn't watch them, have green fly to match. Sometimes George remembers how it all came about. He knows now that he made the right decision, that his move is now justified by everything around him. He knows it most of all when he looks at the new and remembers the old. In her own domestic kingdom, Mrs. Mackay feels that she's only now beginning to live. For the first time, she has space. In the old days, cooking a meal was an ordeal. In her new home, cooking is so easy that she sometimes feels almost guilty. Yes, it's a good life that George and his wife have built up for the family. Problems have gone, except one. The only time the family is ever divided is at mealtime. looming sinisterly over Saturday is always the thought of school on Monday. Children will be delighted to know that Glenrothes is well endowed with schools. The whole range of schools, primary, secondary and high school, is incorporated in the plan for Glenrothes. To her, life's all fingers and thumbs. This one's going to grow up to be a bank teller. Schools are frauds. They lure you in with plasticine and bottles of milk. Then next thing they hit you over the head with an isosceles triangle. Domestic science, a cold, hard, formal name for what any woman will tell you isn't a science but an art. For the boys, technical training. It's here that these isosceles triangles make sense. Glenrothes planners have been careful not to put all their industrial eggs in one basket. Their aim has been to provide a wide range of employment. This factory makes electronic components. Work for young women. The Scottish Milk Marketing Board has established a large creamery at Glenrothes. Plastics, material with a future. This new factory provides many more opportunities for employment. And there's a factory making coal cutting equipment. Drums revolve in a thriving paper mill. A new town providing new industries. New industries providing new employment and new opportunities. Opportunities for George's family. New factories are springing up quickly. You daren't tell a stranger to go to the third factory on the left. By the time he gets there, it'll be the fifth. A busy new town, creating its own history and tradition. And naturally, some days are importantly different from others. Notice the hat. The great day is over. The bunting hangs dark and still, and the pageantry remains only in the sunset sky. Today, great though it was, is already something for memories. Tomorrow is another day, and it is towards tomorrow that we must look. For tomorrow is the true landscape of Glenrothes.